About 9 months ago, I developed a theme configurator in Power Apps to allow you and your users to generate your own theme for the app. And then they would save the value for the next time the user comes in to your application. Well, I thought, let's take advantage of the new components feature. Let's build it out as a component. So I came up with this. It's not fully built. I just built it about an hour ago. But what I have here, I actually have three components. I have a header component, I have a footer component, and each of these components contain input variables to change the background color of the change their respective background colors. Literally, on my theme component, let's go here to the components feature. If you don't know how to turn this on, it doesn't come on automatically. You have to go into File, go to App Settings, Advanced Settings, and then scroll all the way to the bottom under Experimental Features and click the toggle button for components. And then you'll see this new tab. So, like I said, I have my header component, and it has a, what is it? I clicked the wrong spot. I put an input variable for header color, and a for the footer, I have a background, a variable. Input variable named background color. Probably should have named them the same, but I didn't. Let's go here to the theme configurator, and I have a set of text boxes that will be the place values for their various components within your application, and you can add more. You just make this bigger and just to start adding more. And then I have a swatch to show you the actual color. In the text box, you can input the name, such as blue, red, yellow, orange, whatever, or the hex value. Then I have a second swatch that will show you what it will look like at a faded value, at a different value. And I set its fill value by passing in to the color fade function the value, the text value of this text box. The fill value of this swatch. And then I fade it out by passing the value of this slider to the value function, and then divide that by an arbitrary number. I chose 100. You could choose whatever number you wish, whatever suits your needs. And if you ever get stuck, I have a button here that launches another web browser and will take the user to the I don't have it open right now. I'll get to that. Here it is. Where was it? Still early. So, I have a button here. It launches a browser window. It takes you to the Material Design Color Tool. And from there, you can copy whatever value you want. Okay? Let's go back to the main screen. And let's see this in action. So I want the header to be blue. I don't want it to be that blue. I want it to be just a slight hint of the blue. I'm not a designer, so bear with me. I'm going to use that color I copied. And I'm just going to change it to a slight color, slight hue of it as well. And I'm in the process of writing a blog post about how I did this, and I'll post a URL in the show notes down below. Thank you for watching, and well, thank you for joining me on Saturday morning. Have a good day.